Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I'm Jamie V. Thanks for stopping by. I'm going to be sharing with you guys my favorite items all the way from makeup to skincare and more. But if you're excited to see what my current favorites are, then go ahead and keep watching. So the first two things I want to mention are foundations, and we have the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation in Dewy, and then we have the Hourglass Vanish Liquid Foundation. These have both easily become two of my favorite foundations, which is extremely insane because like this was what, $5, and this was $56, but I really, really do love both of these and the way that they go on and the way that they sit throughout the day. So I really, really love these and I wanted to share those with you guys. So I'm not going to be going in any specific order. I'm just going to be grabbing things basically and showing you what they are and how I use them. So the next thing is the Skin Fix Resurface Glycolic Renewing Scrub. So I got this actually from a BoxyCharm, and I didn't use it for the longest time because when I first bought it, I thought it was for your face, like an exfoliant. And then I got it and I was like, oh, this is a body exfoliant. What am I gonna use that for? And then I started using it and I actually love it. It makes my skin super soft and gets rid of a lot of the dead skin. So I really, really love this. You use it before you get into the shower and then you rinse it off. And also, if I look like a trash can, it's because I feel like a trash can. I don't know if I'm getting sick. I don't know what's happening, but I just was like, bleh, all day today. The next item is the Baby Dove Eczema Care Lotion. I use this after all of my showers. It's a soothing cream. So the reason that I use this is because I do have eczema on my body, and any scented lotions used on my body just really, really caused me to have breakouts, so I don't use it. And I found that this is really, really nice to use, and it makes my skin feel so soft and so nice. The next thing I use is, or I've been using, this is actually newer. I usually use the Dove, like unscented or fragrance-free body wash, but I've been using the Dryness Relief. Basically, this is really, really good for my skin. It's a nourishing body wash. So if you have used Dove with the lotion in it and oils in it, basically it's like a moisturizer bath wash put together, and it really, really, really does make my skin so soft and so nice, and I love it. It makes me smell so good too. So going into some makeup things, the first thing I want to share is the Master Eye Prep and Set by Margao. It is just the eye primer set. Basically, you get two creams and then you get a powder here. I don't know if this is concealer or if it's just eye primer, but you get two creams of two different shades and then the setting powder. And when I tell you guys, I first used this when I did the unboxing, I first used it and I was just like, okay, like it's just concealer, it's not that big of a deal. I freaking love this. I freaking love this so much. I'm gonna order a couple of them to have backup. So the next thing I have is actually by Mario as well, and this is the Master Metals. I'm gonna show you this. It's dirty, don't judge me. I haven't cleaned it yet. I use this one all of the time. I can use it with my finger. I'll either just do like a light shimmer because it's like really, really pigmented, or I will do a graphic liner with it, or I'll use the Master Manipulator and I'll do like a very like dramatic look with just the shimmer or just the metal. But dude, I use this for everything. I absolutely love it. It's a very beautiful little palette and very handy to use. So if you don't have this one, you definitely want to check it out. And then I think this is actually the last or only eyeshadow palette, is the KKW Beauty. This is just, it just says eyeshadow palette. I still to this day have no idea what this is called. This is just a very easy, simple 5-pan eyeshadow palette. You have two shimmers, you have a dark shade, you have the transition shade, and then you have just the light shade to either set your primer or to lighten up the underneath the brow bone. So basically, the reason that I love this palette so much is it is such a quick and easy palette to use. I use this for the most part with my hands or one single brush and then use the shimmer with my finger. It's very, very pretty. It's very nice the way it applies, and like I said, it's super easy to use. So I could just toss it in my bag and be out the door and just do like a quick cute little look. Like I looked like I put some effort in, not like now where I look like trash. But you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Two more of my newer favorite items are the Auric Glow Lust, and this is in the shade Pyrite. I literally put this under every single foundation that I use, unless I'm doing like obviously something specific, like a makeup challenge or what have you. This stuff is liquid gold. I love using this by itself. I love just using it at the high points of my face. I love using it under my foundation. I mix it in with my foundation. It's just, there's no way there's no wrong way of using it. Like, I absolutely love it, and the only thing that sucks is I'm gonna run out of this extremely fast. So either I'm using it too much and I need to calm down, or I'm using too much of it and it's unnecessary. Either way, I'm obsessed. Like, this, ugh. If I could pick a single favorite item and just do that, that would be the one. So the next item that I've actually been using, and this is a little more recent, this is the Water Jelly Hydrating Primer. This stuff, when I tell you it feels like I'm literally putting water just into my skin, that's exactly what it feels like. It literally feels like I'm just drenching my face in water. Like, it just, I know that sounds silly because you're like, oh, it's primer, you don't want it to be like wet, but it absorbs and that's fine. But it's just that first moment of hydration, it just feels so good on the face, so good. So a couple other items I have, this one is actually a newer toothpaste I've been trying. I've been using the Hello one, which is more of a natural toothpaste, but I don't find that it was getting my teeth as white as I would prefer. So I've been trying the Crest Pro Health, and it's the gum and enamel repair with advanced whitening. The problem is with me and whitening is that my gums are very sensitive to that. I have very, very, very sensitive teeth and sensitive gums, and it will hurt if I use too much whitening stuff too consistent. So I was like, oh, I don't want to try this, but that stuff just was not whitening my teeth the way I like. And this stuff is amazing. Like, when I tell you, I don't have a single problem. I do not have a single problem. So if you have sensitive teeth, this might be something you really, really want to look into. So the next two things are lip glosses. They are both by Fenty. I have this one in Glass Slipper, and then this one in Fenty Glow. Honestly, I just grabbed these two because I have so many of them, but I basically like the whole gloss brand from her, all of the gloss bombs, the creams, the regulars, whatever. They're amazing. I use these all of the time. I use them over lipstick. I use them by themselves. Sometimes I'll even mix them together. Sometimes I'll use them with a lip liner. Like, they're just so beautiful. It's one of literally my favorite lip gloss brands of all times. I hope that she never stops making these. They smell good. They feel nice. They're not sticky. They're not thick, but they're not watery. Like, it's such a hard description, but they're just freaking perfect. So I absolutely love these. I do love the creams a little bit more than the regular ones, just because they have more pigment to them. So the next thing is such a random item, but this is a candle I got from TJ Maxx for like $12. And I don't know, it says Red Leaf Home. So I'm assuming that that is the brand. Yes, Red Leaf Home is the brand. It smells so good. It's like a citrusy, beautiful scent, and I burn this all of the time, and it still has so much in there, and the scent is like a perfect strength. Like, it's not too strong, it's not too like weak where you can't smell it, and I just think it's so stinking cute. The little label, there's nothing else really on there to kind of distract. It's just a beautiful little sticker, and oh, so good. I love this. I actually don't mind candles from TJ Maxx, but sometimes I find that they're not as strong as I would prefer them to be. So the next thing I have are these earrings that I also got from TJ Maxx, which is a crescent moon and a sun, and I wear these all of the time. They're so beautiful. They're so cute. They're so fun. They're just, oh my god, they're just my vibe. I wish I could find more earrings like these. I love these. So the next makeup item, it's such a weird situation to me. I bought this and I think I bought it from Sephora, maybe Ulta. I don't remember. I bought it to try it. It's very small. This is the Dewy Set Setting Spray by ABH. And let me tell you what, I'm going to get it in the full size. I hope they have the full size. First of all, it feels so nice on the skin. Second of all, it is so dewy. When I tell you I put this on my makeup and my makeup looks like I am shining in like a good way, I absolutely, absolutely love this. And it's so small. And I want to say I've used it maybe like 6 times. A little goes a long way, I will tell you. I had the one time I did do way too much and it was like dripping down my neck and I was like, oh. But I use this and then I use my fan to dry it, and then I go on with the second round and I use my fan to dry it, and my skin just looks so glowing and it smells so good. So the next makeup item is the Foaming Lashes by Lunar Beauty. This is in the shade, in the style Luna. So the reason I picked the Luna lashes is because I have all of them, but these are the ones that I wear every single makeup look, and I have since I bought them. I'm sure the other ones are stunning, and I can't wait to try them, but I am so obsessed with this style lash. Like, I cannot express to you guys. I just can't, like, I cannot. The lash is so beautiful. The container is beautiful. Everything about this lash is just stunning. It's super full. It's tapered. So, so pretty. Like, I had them on, I think I've had them on a couple of videos now. I will definitely link my decluttering video or the Jaclyn video up here, because I know I most definitely had them on there, but I need to try the other styles for sure, but I've just been like obsessed with the Luna one. So I'm probably, I think they're sold out. I'm pretty sure they're sold out. So when he comes back in stock with them, I'm probably gonna buy like a shit ton, and that's insane. And I'm sure, you know, you'll think I'm insane, but I'm gonna do it anyways. So the next thing I have is Twisted Sister Foaming Curl Whip Mousse. So this is so amazing and so life-changing. It is a kind of thick consistency, so if you do not have thick hair, thick kind of coarsey hair, I would stay away from this because it will probably weigh your hair down and make it feel kind of sticky and oily. But this is coconut, avocado, almond, and honey. It foams, curls, and controls frizz. So you use this, it's best to use it. You can use it when it's wet, but it's best to use it when it's dry. And I will literally pump it in my hand and kind of like rub it between both hands and go through each strand and just like bring my curls back to life again. It is a very heavy and thick formula. So if you have thin hair, even if it has a little curl to it, I would not use this. But I got this from TJ Maxx for like $6. And my Girls with Curls is my favorite hair stuff, but this isn't bad. I don't like the smell, I will tell you that. So the next hair item are my clippies. I got these from Amazon. I got 12 of them, I think, for like, I wanna say $5 maybe, and I absolutely love these. I use them when I'm doing makeup. I use them when I'm just tossing my hair up, trying to do other stuff around the house. If I don't have a hair tie, they hold very well. So the next thing is very surprising, but it is the Crazy in Love perfume that I found at TJ Maxx, just chilling on a shelf. I showed you guys this one in my perfume collection, which I'll put right here, but I have fallen in love with this spray, and it's so pretty. I don't even know who it's by. It was just chilling in TJ Maxx, just like this, not in a box. I know it's called Crazy in Love, and maybe I can Google it. I haven't even tried that, but it smells so good. It has like some floral, but some citrus. It's just such a lovely scent, and it cost me $9.99. So jot that down. So the last things are makeup brushes. So, but very specific makeup brushes, so that's kind of strange, but yes. So lately I have been loving putting my concealer on with a makeup brush. This is a Japanesque 718 brush. It's just a dense kind of like flat top kabuki brush, but small, very small. And I just use it to just get in under my under eye and really press that product in there. I don't know why I've just been obsessed with using makeup brushes lately and not beauty blenders. I just find that it does such a better coverage, and this is such a perfect brush. I love this brush. I think I got this at TJ Maxx, so if you guys know of any other brushes that are similar to this, let me know because I need more. So then the next two, this one is the Alamar. I think that's the brand. And this is a brightening brush, so it is a flat tapered brush. It's not fluffy, if you can see that. And I use that for my setting powder, and I have found that this is just perfect to get like in the little small areas of my under eye and get around my nose and wherever else I'm placing powder. But I find that it's very like precise. So I've been loving this. I think I got this in like a BoxyCharm. I honestly have no idea, but I'm pretty sure I got it in a BoxyCharm, but I love it. And then the next thing is the brush that I got from Ulta. It's a Morphe 503, M503. It is a very flat tapered brush. I use this actually now for packing and placing color. I believe it is like a blending brush originally, but I don't use it for that. I got this on sale for like $4. I use it just to pack and place color, and then I will also use it to pack and place color in the crease if I'm going directly in there, because it is so pointy at the tip here. But I love this. I try not to like move it because I want it to keep that shape, because I think, like I said, it is a blending brush. brush, but I love, it just goes doo, doo, doo. I just literally pack on so much color on the outer corner with it and then blend it out with a different brush, but it's so precise and it's such a good, like the fibers are so good. I absolutely love this brush. It's definitely a more recent brush though. I want to say that. Like I just got it in the Ulta haul I did. It's like a big clearance Ulta haul, but it's definitely become one of my favorite brushes and I use it for like all the colors on the outer corner and inner crease. So loving it. That is it guys for today's video. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed seeing what my current favorite goodies are. Let me know what you are currently enjoying or what your current favorite item is, whether it's beauty, it's household, it's decor, whatever it is. Comment below and let me know. And as always guys, if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel. I do 6 videos every single week and you do not want to miss out on those. And I will see you on the next one. Bye.